got me crazy for your love.
Hi everyone, this is Lady 2 and 3 from imvu.com. Sorry, but my recording program's still not working, so all of this is going to be done in pictures today. I hope y'all like pictures. Well, let's get started. I'm going to show you how to make a mesh of yours reflective in SketchUp. I'll also show you how to make your furniture reflective in SketchUp. So right now I'm assuming you already have your room mesh all textured and set up the way you want to do it. What you have to do is copy all of it, all except your standing nodes, and duplicate it. The same way that we duplicated nodes, which would be you make it a group, you tap M, you tap Control, and then you just move it over just a smidgen and you'll notice that you start getting double vision on your mesh. That means that you have created a second mesh, you've duplicated it, but you want it to line up exactly with your other mesh. So move it right back to where it goes. Move it so it's in line with the other mesh. After you know you have your second mesh copied, you right click, flip along, and groups blue or group blue, whichever one it says on yours. And then it should look like this. If it does look like this, then it means that you have successfully copied your original mesh and are ready to go. If it doesn't, you're going to need to go back and select your group, tap M, tap Control, and duplicate your previously made mesh. If it works, we're ready to go on. So let's go on. Your second mesh now should already be selected, so you're going to tap O or hit the orbit button so that you can see the blue axis line that's not touching any part of the mesh. You see on this one that the blue axis line is touching the mesh. That's not what you want. And you're going to click somewhere up at the top and drag down. This is the easiest way to make sure that your second mesh is in line with your top mesh. You can see that in this picture that the dark blue lines is the second mesh that I am moving, and you'll notice that inside of it, instead of it being the red for the floor, it's the gray. That means that I haven't moved it all the way down. So we need to click on the blue axis to move the mesh so that it mirrors our top mesh. After you have them lined up, you need to explode both meshes. Both groups, your top group and your bottom group. I suggest exploding the bottom group first just so that we can work with it. After you have exploded it, you will need to get rid of, in my case, it was the red floor, but now it looks like a red ceiling. You have to delete that, otherwise things get all messed up. So your image should look something like this. Now the funny thing about making a room reflective is the secret is texturing. You notice on the image before that my textures mirrored my top textures. In this case, now you can do it either way, but I'm going to teach you to do it this way so you can have more elaborate, exciting meshes to work with. And I'll have an example of why I did it this way at the end. So what I did here is that I changed the textures to match texture-wise. That's kind of hard to explain. I'll be able to show a little bit later. But it's the same way to texture. Like, I have three squares of texture, but they're different colors. And you'll see why when we get closer to the end. So, save everything, export it. You're going to use plugins, mesh out, export, untextured faces, just like we do a regular room, and we're going to derive from the 10860, which is just the regular IMVU room basic drivable. After you upload your mesh, your material should all be blank with the exception of M001 and M00. What you need to do at this point is to have a separate color texture, like I have M01 that's red or excuse me, M00 that's red, M01 that's yellow, etc., etc., you need to give each of them something separate, and we'll change it from there. But first stop is to make sure each one has its own individual, unique texture. After you upload it, or after you apply changes, it should look just like this. Now you can see what I was talking about when I said that my textures on top matched my textures on bottom. They were just a different color. Technically it's a different texture, but it's textured the same amount of times on each plane. I know that's redundant and it's kind of hard to say, but if you don't do it the way it looks right now, things will just be messed up for you. I wish you could see my hands waving around and trying to explain how important this is. So if your room looks like this so far, you are doing good. Do not worry, we're getting there. Here is the first application of our secret, aka texturing. I know that my M02 for me is the floor texture. So what I have to do is I have to go in and change the opacity map to something gray, a darkish gray. You can, you know, save the image and just collect that picture, set it to blending, set it to two-sided. If you have to upload your own 256 by 256 or it won't work. If you just use the opacity map provided by Imvu, it'll turn out black and it just won't work, so make sure you put in your own. If you did it right, your floor should be see-through now.
What's that?
You'll notice on my mesh that my M01 and my M03 are opposite of each other. That means that when I retexture, I'm going to want to put them as the same texture. Here's an example of them wrong. So on this, I uploaded my M01 and my M03 as two separate textures, or two unique textures. You'll notice that things just don't match up in the reflective. It looks like you have a separate room underneath the floor rather than your wall reflecting in the floor. Now, here I went ahead and I added a separate floor texture so it was easier to see the reflection, and I changed my M01 and my M03, the corresponding textures, to the exact same texture. They're no longer unique, they're now the same, and you can see how they look reflective now compared to what it was before. Ta-da! So now all you have to do to finish up making your reflective room mesh is just go through and texture everything the way you want it to be textured. Then you submit it and you're finished. Now this is the reason that I had you texture your top and your bottom separately. If you want it to look more realistic than some of the meshes out there, you want to be able to make your reflective bottom side chromatic. Alright, that's the wrong word, but what I'm pretty much saying is you want it black and white. You'll notice that my top is in color and my bottom is black and white, no color at all. This makes it look more realistic. It makes it look like you have a colorful wall reflecting into a dark floor. Now, a lot of meshes don't do it that way. Or they'll have it so you can texture it that way, but most people, when they derive, they don't texture it that way. They make it so that your walls and your reflected walls are the same color, so it just looks like you have a very bright, shiny floor. So you can do it either way, but this is the reason that I showed you how to do it with texturing them separately. Honestly, that's all there is to it, so let's get on to furniture just really quick. Here's the chair mesh that I'm going to be working with. It's pretty basic, it's got two textures, so make your mesh and then come back. After you have made a copy of your mesh, remember, tap M, tap Control, just move it to the side. You're going to right-click your mesh, click Flip Along, and then click Blue Direction. That will make your mesh look like this. Following the steps we used to make our room, we need to bring the soon-to-be reflective part of the mesh down so that it mirrors our top part. After that, bring up the client and derive from any empty furniture. I believe the Imvu empty furniture is 12908. When you upload, your mesh should look like this. It doesn't look right. It just looks like a mesh on top of itself. Of course it doesn't look right. But when you load a reflective room mesh into the client, or after you've uploaded your mesh, saved it, it's for sale, etc., and you use it in a reflective room, you now have a reflective mesh. You can see it through the top where you can sit. You can see it through the glass of the bottom. Ladies and gentlemen, that is all there is to it. Now go forth and make awesome reflective meshes.